In this video, I'm talking about what to expect when acclimating to a new set of hearing aids. Coming up. Hi guys, Cliff Olson, Doctor of Audiology and founder of Applied Hearing Solutions in Phoenix, Arizona. And on this channel, I cover a bunch of hearing related information to help make you a better informed consumer. So if you're into that, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And don't forget to click the bell to receive a notification every time I post a new video. It is a rare occasion that the first time hearing aid user can tolerate their full amount of amplification up to their hearing loss prescription at their initial fitting appointment. I mean, the thought that you could go from a hearing loss that you may have had for a number of years to the full amount of amplification in order to treat that hearing loss instantaneously just isn't realistic. So let's discuss what to expect when acclimating to a new set of hearing aids, and number one is everything will sound louder. There is a strong possibility that the auditory processing centers of your brain have not been functioning to their full capacity in a number of years, and now you're going to ask them to go ahead and wake up and start working again. I think of it a lot like when you wake up in the morning and you go and turn the light on and you have to squint a little bit because your eyes aren't used to the light. It's the same thing with your hearing, only you've probably gone quite some time with some amount of hearing decline. So then when you bring all of that sound back, of course your brain's not going to be ready for it. When I program my patients at their initial hearing aid appointment up to their full prescription of amplification, 9 out of 10 individuals I have to reduce the amount of amplification because it's just too much for them. In fact, this is one of the main arguments for hearing care providers who do not like to use real ear measurement. But the way I see it, the hearing loss prescription that I am trying to match using real ear measurement is my end goal. It is not my starting point. This is a screenshot that I took during the initial fitting of a new hearing aid user. First, I match the patient's hearing loss prescription, which is indicated by the pink hash mark line, with the amplification from the hearing aid, which is indicated by the solid purple line. This helps me to ensure that these prescriptive targets can be achieved with the recommended hearing aid using an appropriate ear mold or dome. Then, I reduce the amount of amplification, which is indicated by the solid pink line, before the patient leaves my office. In most cases, it is a 3-7 decibel reduction across the entire frequency range. This amplification is then added back in during several follow-up visits, usually in 2-3 decibel increments, until the hearing aid wearer once again meets their full prescription, which is where they will hear their best. Now, if you would like to learn more about real ear measurement, then I highly recommend that you watch my video that I will have linked in the description, because it is the single most important thing that you can do to ensure that you receive the maximum amount of performance from your hearing aids. The second thing to expect from your new hearing aids is that some things will sound annoying. Some of the more common sounds that you may find annoying are the sound of the toilet flushing, your vehicle running, the refrigerator running, silverware clinking in the kitchen, and of course, the sound of crinkling paper, all of which can be made particularly more annoying if you happen to have a high frequency hearing loss that you're being treated for. And some individuals may even find the sound of their own voice to be annoying. I mean, think about it. You've gone some amount of time without hearing your own voice up to its full capacity, and then all of a sudden we're gonna bring it back to you in an instant. The good news is most hearing aid wearers get used to these sounds pretty quickly as long as you're wearing your hearing aids consistently. The third thing that you may see an improvement in is your ability to hear in background noise. In a 2017 research study on hearing aid acclimatization by Dawes and Monroe in Ear and Hearing, they identified a subset of new users with moderate hearing loss who wore their hearing aids at least 6 hours per day, experienced significantly improved speech and noise ability by approximately 3 decibels of signal-to-noise ratio, compared with a control group of experienced hearing aid users. Improvements in speech and noise were associated with more consistent hearing aid use and more severe hearing loss. So it would appear that some individuals who are new hearing aid wearers and wear their hearing aids really consistently will see an improvement in background noise, and a 3 decibel signal-to-noise ratio improvement is a big deal. And the fourth thing that you should expect when acclimating to hearing aids is that all of this adaptation should take place in approximately 30 days. Dr. Brian Taylor, one of my favorite audiologists that I've been following for a long time, did a literature review back in 2007 where he identified that in most cases, adaptation to hearing treatment happens inside of 30 days. And while there's limited evidence to even suggest that adaptation occurs past 30 days, it's actually kind of a good thing because this means that when you're inside of your initial fitting window with hearing aids, you should be experiencing a lot of adaptation really quickly. So if your hearing care professional is following best practices, and I will link some PDFs to best practices in the description of this video, then you should be getting through your adaptation phase pretty quickly. However, just because it's unlikely that you'll receive a significant amount of acclimatization over a long period of time with hearing aids, it doesn't mean that it won't have long-term benefit for you cognitively. There have been a lot of studies that have come out that have been linking hearing loss to cognitive decline, and the best thing that we know to recommend is to actually treat your hearing loss. So if you're a new hearing aid user and you're struggling early on in treatment, just give it some time because you need to get over the hump before you start realizing the maximum benefit with hearing aids. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below. If you liked the video, please share it. And if you want to see other videos just like this one, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Also, feel free to check out my website, drcliffaud.com.